Psst, listen for reveal and a devotion. One evening, outside of the local bookstore, Becky Botsford and many of the city's residents eagerly await the midnight release of Princess Triana and the Ogre of Castlebum.
Oh, this is so exciting. We're finally going to find out what happens to Princess Triana.
It feels like forever since the last book came out. The wait has been unbearable.
I know. I can't believe they just left poor Princess Triana hanging from a cliff like that.
Wait, I thought she was being forced to marry that smelly count. No, you're thinking of book four.
Yes, of course. I knew that. I've read it. Several times. And I've heard the book on tape. Several times.
There sure are a lot of people in line. I hope they have enough copies.
What? This cannot be the line for the Princess Triana book.
Oh, yes, it is. And the back of the line is down there.
No! There must be some mistake. I'm early.
Not early enough, obviously.
Oh, Mother, this is an outrage! You people are not supposed to be here!
Hi, Miss Libri.
Hi, Becky. How's my best customer?
Anxious to get my hands on Princess Triana and the Ogre of Castlebum.
Becky is a very devoted Princess Triana fan.
Devoted? That means when you love something so much that you give it a lot of your time. Like the way we're devoted to each other. You're welcome. This midnight release party was a great idea.
Thanks.
So, Miss Libri, do you know what happens in the new book?
Oh, no. The author didn't want to reveal any details about the story until the official release. They're keeping all the books under lock and key at the publisher's building until the stroke of midnight.
Publisher's building, eh? I just may be the first one to read this book after all. Mother, I forgot to change into my waiting in line shoes. They're in the car. Back in two shakes.
Fine, dear.
I'm coming for you, my princess.
Oh, he's up to something. Dad, we'll be right back.
Where are you going?
I have to ask a girl in line where she got her Princess Triana inflatable jumpsuit.
Okay, I'll be here.
Word up!
I don't know, Mick. This Ogre of Castlebum sure looks like a mean guy. He's so big.
Daddy Ogre's a wimp. Princess Triana could take him out with a wand tied behind her back.
Well, that was easy. Good work, robot. Now then, Princess Triana, where are you? Aha! Come to theater.
Drop that book, Toby!
Ha! Word girl! I don't think so. I must know what happens in the story before anyone else!
But that's unfair to everyone waiting in line!
I know, but aren't you tempted? Just a little?
No. Now put down the book and back away from the crate!
My word, girl, you do look lovely when you're angry. I wonder what you'd look like if you were furious.
If you want to read Princess Triana and the Ogre of Castlebum, you're going to have to wait in line like the rest of us.
You may have stopped me this time, Word Girl, but I will get that book before midnight, whether you like it or not. I'm a little teapot, short and stout.
I can't see! He's gone.
Yeah, but at least the books are safe. Thanks, Word Girl.
Meanwhile, back in line...
As if it isn't bad enough having to wait in the line, but I have to do it with the likes of this riffraff?
Oh, I know. It's horrible.
I was including you in that riffraff.
Oh, that's funny. I was including you. Double humph.
Oh, hi, Becky. So, should I get you that Princess Triana inflatable jumpsuit for your birthday?
Inflatable jumpsuit? Oh, right. No, don't bother. It wasn't that well made. One little monkey bite and it popped. Right, Bob?
I see you winking. What are you two up to?
It won't be long now, everyone. The books are in an armored truck and are on their way to the store as we speak.
Hey!
There he goes again. Let's follow him.
Where are you going, Becky? The books are almost here.
Bob forgot to apologize to that girl for eating her jumpsuit.
If you owe her any money, Bob, it's coming out of your allowance.
I want to know what happened to Prince Van Landingham. He disappeared 2 books ago, and they've never revealed where he went.
Lovely to see you again, gentlemen. But if you wouldn't mind, I'd like a few moments alone with the princess.
Right there, Toby!
Oh, hello, Word Girl. Here to stop me or join me?
Stop you?
Too bad. I have devoted my entire evening to reading this book before anyone else, and I will!
That wasn't too hard. What, no? My robot!
What's that now? Sorry, I wasn't paying attention. I've just been doing a bit of reading.
Hey, no fair! Put that down!
I don't think I can put it down, Word Girl. It's just too good. Already there are some very surprising developments. Would you like me to reveal some of them?
You wouldn't.
Oh, I would. For example, did you know that Prince Van Landingham is in fact still alive?
Stop! Don't tell me!
Yeah, Toby! Don't reveal what happens!
Reveal?
Reveal means to give away a secret or show something that's hidden, like whether or not Prince Van Landingham is alive.
He is!
What?!
Or revealing whether or not the princess falls from the cliff.
She does!
No!
But the bubble-breathing dragon saves her.
Oh, thank goodness!
Wait, Toby! Don't reveal anymore! If we already know what happens, it'll ruin all the fun!
Oh, I'm finished. And so are you!
must break free! Princess Triana and the Ogre of Castlebum. No, I can't, but I want to. No! I have to at least try to break out of here. Oh, well, I'm stuck. Guess I have no choice. Hey, Huggy! How'd you get in here? It was open! Funny! I guess I should have checked that. Right, well, time to go after Toby! Word up! Whoops, must have forgotten. It was in my hand. Okay, word up!
Toby has escaped with a stolen copy of Princess Triana and the Ogre of Castlebum. Will Word Girl and Captain Huggyface track him down before midnight? Will Toby's secret reading spot in the belly of his robot ever be revealed by me right now?
Nice.
Book is somehow more enjoyable when you're doing something bad just by reading it. Oh, it's you.
Step away from the book, Toby.
But it was just getting good.
Why? What's happening in it? Right. Put it down, Toby. End of story.
Are you sure? Wouldn't it interest you to know that Princess Triana has reunited with the handsome knight, Sir Finvold?
No.
Or how the Ogre of Castlebum may have taken Prince Van Landingham hostage?
Stop revealing the story! You're spoiling it!
Now, robot, attack! Oh, what's this? The princess has turned the tables on the ogre! She's winning! And she's kissing him on the cheek! Aha! Missed me! Now you have to... You ripped out the last pages! Those pages reveal the ending!
Good job, Huggy!
Oh, nice monkey. Nice monkey. No, stop! Spit those out! No! Malfunctioning robot!
Psst.
This is not going to end well.
Excuse me, Mrs. McAllister? Do I even need to say anything?
Ow. Mom, seriously.
Midnight! The book is on sale! Let's go, Huggy!
Oh, there you are. Just in time.
Yeah, thanks for holding our place, Dad.
Sorry. Looks like we're all out.
What?
Oh, sorry, Becky.
No! I knew I should have read it when I had the chance.
What?
Nothing. Let's go home.
Oh, Becky, I'm glad you're still here. I have something for you.
Oh, thank you, Miss Libri!
I had to save one for my most devoted customer.
Thank you!
You're very welcome.
Okay, Bob. Ready to find out what happens to the princess? Wow! Wow! What'd you think? What?
Well, there you have it, devoted Word Girl fans. We made it all the way through the episode, and we didn't even reveal that when Princess Triana kissed the Ogre of Castlebum, he turned back into the long-lost Prince Van Landingham. Can you believe it? Sorry. Tune in next time to see what gets revealed in another exciting adventure of Word Girl!